this lecture, we will go over some significant testing items for hepatitis B. We will quickly locate the basic structures of the hepatitis B virus, list the multiple antigens that the hepatitis B virus carries, and tag the antibodies in responding to these viral antigens. After the quick overview, we will study the individual antigen, its corresponding antibody, and the trend of their presence in the blood throughout the infection, followed by the viral load and the liver function test. Of all five common hepatitis viruses, hepatitis B virus is the only one with a DNA genome. As a matter of fact, it is the smallest DNA virus. There are 10 genome types of hepatitis B DNA, and they are labeled A through J. These genome types are clinically significant. They are strongly correlated to geographical regions. In the United States, genome types A through H can be found, yet the most prevalent ones are A, B, and C. When all types of genomes respond to nucleoside analog equally, they respond to interferon in various degrees. Genome type A has a greater response to interferon, leading to a higher rate of hepatitis B E antigen and hepatitis B surface antigen loss, comparing to genome types B through D. Genome types may be associated with development of seroconversion and complications of cirrhosis and/or hepatocellular carcinoma. Quantity and genome types of DNA help evaluating and guiding the treatment plan. The DNA of hepatitis B is protected by an icosahedral capsid. Then, the outermost layer of hepatitis B virus is the envelope, which includes surface antigen and the double lipid layer. The other important structure in the hepatitis B virus is the secretory protein, which locates in between the layers of capsid and envelope. Hepatitis B virus carries with it many different antigens, to which our body responds. At different stages of infection, these antigens and antibodies vary in the blood. The first antigen is surface antigen, including large, medium, and small hepatitis B surface antigen. E antigen is the secretory protein that is produced by precor gene. It circulates in the host's bloodstream and locates in between capsid and lipid envelope in the virus. The last, but not the least, is the core antigen. Core antigen locates in the capsid which surrounds DNA. Antibodies produced by immune response against hepatitis B virus are three, each targets on the specific hepatitis B antigen. Anti-hepatitis B surface antibody responds to hepatitis B surface antigen. Anti-hepatitis B core antibody responds to hepatitis core antigen. In blood test, we can identify IgM and IgG. Anti-hepatitis B E antibody responds to hepatitis E antigen. Before we start individual antigen and antibody, let's establish one logical reasoning. Antigens will be present in the blood before antibody, because antigen trigger our immune responses, which produce antibodies. In other words, without antigen, there will not be antibody. First antigen is hepatitis B surface antigen. It usually starts rising about 1 month after exposure to the hepatitis B virus, peak at 2 months, and last for 5 months. Hepatitis B surface antigen can be detected in both incubation period and acute hepatitis stage. If hepatitis B surface antigen is present in blood sample 6 months after exposure, a chronic hepatitis B is indicated. One important note here, acute or chronic infection, the presence of hepatitis B surface antigen indicates an active infection. Antibodies against hepatitis B surface antigen can be detected 3 to 6 months after the exposure. It can last for years or lifelong. presence of hepatitis B surface antibodies indicates previous exposure and immunity to hepatitis B. The presence of hepatitis B E antigen indicates an active viral replication. It is detected at the onset of infection and usually lasts for a short period of time should it be an acute infection. In chronic hepatitis B infection, hepatitis B E antigen may be present, signifying an ongoing viral replication. However, absence of hepatitis B E antigen is possible in chronic infection. It could be a hepatitis B E antigen negative chronic hepatitis B or simply a state of low viral replication. Hepatitis B E antigen is clinically significant in two ways. One, as stated earlier, E antigen signifies active replication of the virus. And two, it plays a role in inducing immunotolerance to the virus. Immunotolerance phase is the first stage of chronic hepatitis B infection. During this phase, viral replication is active and viral load is high. However, with the presence of an E antigen, our immune response is not activated. Therefore, there is no damage to the liver cells. Hepatitis B E antibodies quickly follow the transient presence of hepatitis E antigen during an acute infection. In chronic infection, these antibodies may last and be detected. Hepatitis B E antibodies is related to decreased ability to cause infection. Hepatitis B core antigen is not detectable in the blood. Its existence is indirectly proven by the presence of anti-hepatitis B core antibodies. There are two types of hepatitis B core antibodies, IgM and IgG. The former is the first antibody responding to the infection, while the latter appears later and lasts longer into the state of chronic infection. Hepatitis B core IgM is the first antibody responding to hepatitis B infection. It can be an indicator for acute hepatitis B infection, especially during the time window in which hepatitis B surface antigen had disappeared, yet hepatitis B surface antibody hasn't developed. Hepatitis B core IgG is the antibody that remains in the blood for the longest time after recovery from hepatitis infection. Viral load is obtained via polymerase chain reaction test. It is especially important for chronic hepatitis B infection. Together with liver enzyme and serologic markers, viral load provides information for the outcomes of antiviral therapy. Viral load is not usually tested during acute hepatitis infection. In addition, it is prescribed after receiving results of serologic markers. Viral load varies throughout the course of infection, depending on the stages of chronic infection. Liver function can be tested via comprehensive metabolic panel or via individual liver enzymes. Here listed are the normal range for liver enzymes, protein, albumin, and bilirubin. When the liver is intact and healthy, the test results for these items should be within normal range. In contrary, if the levels of liver enzymes increase, the liver cells must be damaged. Bilirubin level is correlated to the symptom of jaundice. In addition, some other test items may signify the status of the liver. These test items may not be routinely ordered for hepatitis B patients. However, as a nurse, we should know that these testing results might be abnormal should the liver function is affected by hepatitis infection. We should plan patient care accordingly. In acute hepatitis B infection, the serologic antigens and antibodies most likely would be presented as indicated in this graph. I memorize it as antigen before antibodies in the order of SECCES, success. The serological markers for hepatitis B in chronic infection is as shown in this graph. Here, let's highlight the difference between acute and chronic hepatitis B infection. Hepatitis B surface antigen still is the first marker, and it will last during chronic infection. Hepatitis B E antigen will be present for months to a few years until E antigen negative phase is achieved. Hepatitis B E antibody still follows the disappearance of E antigen. However, in acute infection, E antibodies showed up much earlier, and in chronic infection, this antibody will not show up until months or years later. Thank you for watching this video.